أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين، محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. And may his peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that indeed Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. يا أحباب رسول الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه، يقول ربنا جل وعلا في كتابه الكريم: يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد، وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا. ويقول جل وعلا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كلوا من طيبات ما رزقناكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran: O children of Adam, take your ornaments at the places of prayer عند كل مسجد، وكلوا واشربوا، eat and drink. However, do not be excessive. وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. Do not be excessive and do not be wasteful. You know, nowadays, subhanAllah, amongst all the economic challenges that people are talking about, that people are facing, there is also a lot of talk about healthcare and healthcare reform and debates about healthcare, people holding town hall meetings about healthcare. Because this is important. A component of us human beings, in order to function properly, we must be healthy. So the talk itself is appropriate. And the talk itself is very timely, simply because people are suffering from healthcare and the consequences of healthcare. Now in the Quran, subhanAllah, healthcare is so important. It is so important that Allah calls his own book Shifa, healing. That is beautiful. Allah refers to his book, to his words, to the Quran, as this is a book that is in it, there is shifa, there is healing in it for mankind. And it is also a constant dua that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would make: Allahumma aafina wa'afu anna. Oh Allah, always keep us in the state of well-being, and oh Allah, efface, pardon our sins. We come here to Taraweeh, and as we are in the Qunut prayer in the Witr, the Imam is leading and he's making dua. And most likely in that dua he's saying, Allahumma matti'na bi asma'ina wa absarina wa quwwatina ma abqaytana. O Allah, have us enjoy our hearing, our sight, our strength, so long that we live. Well, why is this? Because physical health is the very first and most important component in us being in the state of well-being. We need to be physically healthy, emotionally healthy, and we also need to be psychologically healthy as well. But inshallah, we're going to concentrate on this one, the physical health aspect of it. You know, subhanAllah, the very first step in attaining physical health is by watching out what it is that we put in us. What type of nutrition come into our body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses this issue so beautifully. Allah begins by talking about kind. What kind do you eat and what kind do you not eat? So the verse says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. O ye who believe, eat of the goods that we have given you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would further be specific: eat that which is halalan tayyiba. Eat and make sure that what you're eating is halal, meaning that we gained it through legitimate, through lawful means. Stolen food is not halal. Food that in itself is not appropriate, is not kosher for us, is not good. We don't eat it. So Allah said that there are two conditions for the eat, for the food to begin with to be consumed. It must be halal where you get it from. And then the food itself must be tayyib. It must be good. And it must be good for you. Because certain types of food may be halal, but they're not good for you. If you're diabetic, sugar is halal. But to you, sugar is not good. It's not tayyib. So these two conditions, Allah speaks about them, says that you must abide by these two conditions. Number one, the food must be halal and it must be tayyib, it must be good for you. The second condition, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how much, the quantity that we eat. So it said, Ya Bani Adam, خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد. He said, all children of Adam, take your ornaments at every masjid. Some people erroneously think that if I look really messed up, then I'm really religious. If I look like I am miskeen, then I am closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not the case. Rather, Allah said, that is not what indicates religiosity. When you come to the masjid, make sure you look good. You be looking nice, you smelling nice. You wear stuff that you would not wear anywhere else. But subhanAllah, some of us would wear it into the masjid. So to begin with, Allah said, wear and wear good. And then, again, because erroneously some people may think that if I give up eating, if I give up drinking, that will make me closer to Allah. So Allah said, no, this is not how you get closer to me. So Allah said, kulu washrabu, eat and drink. However, do not be excessive. Wala tusrifu, do not be wasteful. As we speak, my brothers and sisters, 1/3 of adults in the US are overweight, are obese. The estimation is that about 60 million people are overweight. 90% of these people are overweight, not because they have big bones, like we would like to say sometimes, not because, you know, they have thyroid problems, even though that's an issue with some people. 90% are overweight because of overeating. We overeat. Unbelievable how much eating we do. And subhanAllah, sometimes we eat simply because we're bored. It's not, I have not yet seen people who eat because they're hungry. People eat because they're bored. You call up a person, what are you doing? Nothing. I think I'm going to make me a sandwich. عملنا شغل خلينا نتسلى عليها. طب جعان لا بس نتسلى. That's how people talk. Say that we're bored. Let's, you know, bring in some food to this. Bring in some entertainment by means of food. You go to the movies, you make sure that you have your popcorn and you have your, you know, your drinks with you. You're watching TV, that's what we do. You get in your car in the morning, you get the coffee and the donuts. Lunchtime, of course, you've got to eat. In between, you have to snack because the doctor said it was good for you. So we do this and we overeat. And we even overeat a lot more when the food is free. We love free food. People would be full. Say, but you're eating. Said, it's free, akhi. You know, these chances don't come by every day. So we eat and we overeat. Wallahi, you see people, they get up and they loosen their belt and they try to push it down so that they can eat a lot more. And that is not good. It is not healthy. But yet, we do this. Wallahi, I have seen people who go to the restaurant, an all-you-can-eat restaurant. They come back and the first thing they do is they open the fridge. Oh, you just ate. And you ate from an all-you-can-eat place. You come in and the very first thing that you do is you open the fridge. Watch kids as they're watching TV. Between commercials, the first commercial they run and they get their Sunny D. And then the second commercial, it's the chips. And then the third commercial, it's the cookies. And then the fourth commercial, they just go open the fridge and they come back, they don't take anything. Why? Because we've gotten used to this idea that we just eat, we're constantly eating. So Allah said, eat. Allah said, drink. But do not be excessive. Do not cross the bounds. And when you look into some of the statistics that people do, it's unbelievable. They say that the average person in the US consumes about 64 pounds of sugar a year. That is a lot of sugar. We're talking about, they said that in 1997, in the US people spent $54 billion on soft drinks. Did you know that fast food restaurants, they make more money on soft drinks than they do on the actual food that you buy from them? The money is not in the Big Mac. The money is not in the Whopper and the burger. Say that really the money is in the soft drinks. The average in the US is 868 cans of soda by a student who is in high school. Boys. 868. That's almost two a day. That's a lot. So subhanAllah, what we're doing is, alhamdulillah, we may be eating that which is halal. But it is not tayyib. May be lawful, but it's not good for us. And then on top of that, we do it and we do it excessively. They're talking about 300,000 people die every single year because of obesity. We're talking about the healthcare cost of overweight is $100 billion. $100 billion are being spent simply because people overeat. And again, my brothers and sisters, that is not acceptable. So Islam comes to tell us that yes, be healthy. But being healthy is your responsibility. Do not jeopardize your health and then blame the insurance companies. Do not jeopardize your own health and live a lifestyle that is not healthy and then expect the government to bail us out. It said, no. وَإِنَّ لِبَدَنِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقٌ. And your body has a right over you. You have to be good to your body. Your body is an amana. We've been entrusted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to care for our bodies. So that is a responsibility. So the first person who is responsible for your health is you. We are responsible for our own health. And that begins by what it is that we are allowing inside us. And it begins by eating that which is good and not being excessive there. يا أحباب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تأملوا معي في هذه القاعدة الذهبية. Look into this, what we call just golden rule that is passed on to us by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَا مَلَأَ ابْنُ آدَمْ وِعَاءً شَرًّا مِّن بَطْنِهِ. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, son of Adam, a child, man, human being, does not fill a vessel worse than his own tummy. He said, a person does not fill a vessel worse than his own tummy. The worst thing to ever fill up is your own tummy. مَا مَلَأَ ابْنُ آدَمِ وِعَاءً شَرًّا مِّن بَطْنِهِ. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, حَسْبُ ابْنُ آدَمَ مِنَ الطَّعَامِ أو حَسْبُ ابْنِ آدَمَ مِنَ الطَّعَامِ لُقَيْمَاتٍ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَهِ. He said, it suffices. A child of Adam, man, you know, small morsels to keep his back straight. يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَهُ. A صُلْب, a ظهر. He said that all you need is that which will keep you straight, meaning that you're able to function. You have your strength on you. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives us an idea of how do you do this. So he said, فَثُلُثٌ لِطَعَامِهِ وَثُلُثٌ لِشَرَابِهِ وَثُلُثٌ لِنَفَسِهِ. He said, one third of it should be for the food. One third of it should be for the drink. And one third of it for the person to be breathing properly. Sleep apnea. People not being able to sleep at night. I visited a lab where people come to spend the night there because they don't get enough oxygen. So they have to be supplied with the oxygen. They don't spend the night at home. They spend it in that clinic. And I was talking to the person who was in charge. And I said, well, how long is this going to go for? And he would tell me, he looked at me and he said, all these people, they just need to lose weight and their problems will be solved. It's a catastrophe. Obesity at this point is an American tragedy. It is really sad that this is what is going on with us. تأمل معي في قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الله يبغض كل جعذري جواظ صخاب بالأسواق عليم بأمور الدنيا جاهل بأمور الدين. He said Allah detests every man or woman who are overweight. Now remember, we're talking about being overweight by your own choice. We're not talking about being overweight simply because, you know, you have your own health challenges. No, he said that إِنَّ اللَّهَ Allah detests every man or woman who are engaged in this lifestyle. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would even tell us more what led to this. He said سَخَابٍ بِالْأَسْوَاقِ. You see them all the time in the market. They're doing their fighting and they're constantly doing their shopping. He said عَلِيمٍ بِأُمُورِ الدُّنْيَا. Very knowledgeable about the affairs of this life. We know where the best sales are taking place. You know where buy one get one free is taking place. This we know it very well. And then he said, "Jahilin bi umuri din." Yet when it comes to matters of their religion, they are very ignorant about it. But the point is, with all the talk that is taking place, we have to take charge, and that is just being our own doctor by taking the means of prevention. Now the challenge comes to people who do not have health insurance. And I know that a good number of our community and people around us are suffering from this. People lose their jobs. You lose your insurance. Did you know that 70% of the people who file for bankruptcy because they could not afford their healthcare bills? This is how bad it is. People are filing for bankruptcy because they cannot pay for the medical care that they just received. They say that two things in the US you avoid and most likely you will make it. Don't get sick and don't get sued. Don't get sick and don't get sued. You get sick, you're doomed. You get sick, you get sued, you're also doomed. Why? Because of the financial consequences that are going to come with it. I have people who come to the masjid. They've been sick for a long time and they tell us, we cannot afford to go and see a doctor. Why not? Because I don't have health insurance. Wallahi, I know of people who made it to the ER, to the emergency room, and then they decided, I can't afford this. Their health was so bad, they actually had to go to the emergency room. They made it there and they started thinking, I can't afford this. I can't. So what do? They come back. And that is sad. Subhanallah, that is very sad. That is very sad. When people have to go through this, people are constantly having toothaches and they're having aches all over their body and say, I can't afford this. And nobody deserves to go through that pain, subhanAllah, if we can afford to do something about it. The point is this, my brothers and sisters. Yes, if you do not have health care, that is a challenge. And I know people, wallahi, who've been telling us that this is one of their greatest challenges. That is why we're very grateful to the doctors in our local community. We have doctors who would call me up and say, you know what, whoever needs to see a doctor and they cannot afford it, please send them my way. We have dentists who come to me and they say, do me a favor, I know these are difficult times and people don't take care of their health because they cannot afford it. Please, if somebody needs any help free of charge, please send them my way. To these brothers and sisters, we say, Jazakumullah khair ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them best, because truly they are helping people in getting out of their difficulties. But what's important is, at this point we need to say, I am responsible for my health by watching out what it is that I eat. Now this is the month of Ramadan, and you would think that we as a Muslim community, this will be a great time. You know, in Ramadan you don't eat much. In Ramadan you help your budget because you don't spend a lot of money on food, and you would think, this is it, Ramadan people are going to get healthier. But here is what we do in Ramadan. See how we eat three meals a day? In Ramadan, we take all the three meals and we just eat it at the end of the day. But that's not the point. So I didn't have breakfast, I didn't have lunch, but now I'm going to have my breakfast, my lunch, and my dinner at Maghrib time. Please remember, Ramadan is the month of fasting, not the month of feasting. There is a difference between fasting and feasting. In Ramadan, we feast, we don't fast. You go to the market and you would see the market, people are on top of each other. What happened? Say, oh, it's Ramadan time. We're supposed to be eating less. But we eat a lot more during Ramadan. We stuff it up at Maghrib time and then we wake up and we stuff it up again at Suhoor time. And that defeats the purpose. That defeats the purpose. They say fasting is such a beautiful way of having your body detoxicate all the waste, all the bad stuff that is not good for us, that is in it. Say Ramadan you fast, your body takes a break to get rid of that. But we don't give our bodies that break. We eat and we eat and we eat and we eat. It was said that one time Ibn Umar and one of his friends were walking in the market. And the man said to Ibn Umar, please. Said, I'm looking for medication to help me digest. And he said, what do you mean to help you digest? He said, well, sometimes when I fill up my stomach, you know, I need something to digest it. You know, we fill it up and then we look for soda. That's what we do nowadays. So he said, I want medication to help me digest. And Ibn Umar looked at him and he said, Wallahi mundu 30 sana ma shabi'at. He said, by Allah, it has been 30 years, I have not eaten my full. He said, I don't eat until I fill it up. He said, it has been 30 years. Why is that? Because it became a lifestyle. Unlike the lifestyle that is so unhealthy that we are living today. Alhamdulillah, please inshallah, let us make use of what remains of the month of Ramadan. Get used to it so that inshallah after the month of Ramadan, we can continue this beautiful habit of eating healthy. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثار اقتفى. قالوا قديما لا بأس بالغناء لمن اتقى، والصحة لمن اتقى خير من الغنى، وطيب النفس من النعيم. They say that there is no harm in wealth for those who are righteous, and health for the pious is better than wealth. وطيب النفس, and being in the state of well-being, من النعيم, is a blessing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower all of us and our families with good health, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And make us of those who are responsible and give their dues to their bodies, Ya Rabbal Alameen. So that is one thing about the month of Ramadan. And also the month of Ramadan is the month of giving as well. I know with all the difficulties that are taking place, but one of it is that, you know, we're getting closer to Allah by giving of ourselves. The money that we did not spend on food, we didn't have the coffee, we didn't have this and we did not have that. Well, what happens to that? I say, well, somebody else inshallah can make better use of it. So the month of Ramadan is the month of giving. And what we want to do is, we want to come in as a community and collectively say, I appreciate this masjid. Wallahi, this is a beautiful place. And we're grateful for the people who are making it possible. SubhanAllah, look into the AC that we are in. You know, you hear it and it's a beautiful environment, clean, clean atmosphere. Well, brothers and sisters, you know it and I know it, that it takes money to maintain a place like this. You see us having security outside. You see the place when you walk in, SubhanAllah, it is well facilitated for the comfort of those who are going to come in. And this is not just the responsibility of the people who are in charge, but rather this is the responsibility of everybody. This is my masjid, as much as it's your masjid, as much as it's the masjid of the board in the masjid as well. So what we want to do is collectively say, no, I love this masjid. I want to see this masjid maintained. But this is not only that. You see people who come here and they receive counseling. People lose loved ones and they receive their condolences here. People have happy occasions and it is celebrated in this masjid. People are introduced to Islam and it is done in this masjid. Some of our brothers and sisters who are not as practicing, they come to this masjid and they come to the right path in this masjid as well. People come and read Quran in this masjid. So there is a lot of good that is taking place here. We do not want you to miss out on it. So inshallah, we appeal for your help. We appeal for your support. You know, as you walk out, please help out the masjid. Please make sure that you take some of your zakah money and you give it to the masjid here as well. There are pledge forms. You may not have the money right now, but if you have money throughout the year, please make sure that you share that with the masjid as well. And one final point about Zakat al-Fitr. Please do not wait till the last minute to give out Zakat al-Fitr. Please don't. That is really sad. What we want is we want you to give Zakat al-Fitr now so that we can give it to people now. There is a sister in our community. She said, the other day my daughter was so hungry. Wallahi, she was eating napkins. This is here. It is in Orange County. This is taking place. Well, they come to us and say, I'm sorry, there is no funds in the masjid. We can't do anything about it. But if we were to pay our zakah way ahead of time, pay the zakah ahead of time, so that the money can be taken and it can be shared with these people. You know that the Prophet ﷺ would ask Al-Abbas, his uncle, to give the zakah for the two next years, two coming years. He said, please, there is so much need. Can you give your zakah 2 years in advance? Don't wait till the end of the year, but rather give it to us 2 years in advance. And Abbas would say, please, here is the money. So please do not wait and rush before the Eid prayers. Make sure that the Imam did not start the Salah to put your money in the box. Do it right now. so that inshallah the money is taken and is shared with the people there. And for those who do not have health insurance, alhamdulillah, good news. If you are to visit Access California, it's a social service agency that we have here for all people. Concentration is on the Muslim and the Arab community. Please come over there and we will do what we can. Be it introducing you to doctors who work for pro bono, be it helping you filing the proper paperwork to get health insurance for you and your family. But this is a beautiful service that inshallah that you can make use of. Allahumma ya Rabbi taqabbal minna siyamana. اللهم اجعلنا في شهرنا هذا من الفائزين. اللهم يا رب أعنا على حسن القيام والصيام برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وفك أسرانا وعاف مبتلانا واختم بالصالحات الباقيات آجالنا. اللهم يا رب فرج هم المهمومين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.